suicide. That's who I was. I was an unstoppable force in professional wrestling. The crowd, they loved me, and I steamrolled over anyone that stood in my way for the belt. And when I was finished with them, came my unrivaled trademark finale, the DOA, a finisher so lethal that no one's ever gotten up from it. No one. TNA had no choice but to give me a title shot. I earned it. Then, backstage politics reared its ugly head.
You think you got a title shot, huh? Well, back up, son. Guess again.
This is how it's going down, Trump. It's real simple. The big man said you're going to take a dive, so that's what you're going to do. Take a dive. Got it?
Take it easy, guys. All right, I'll do it. Screw that. There's no way I'm taking a dive on this title shot, especially on national television.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a new champion.
I destroyed him. The crowd went wild, and I was on top of the world. Man, that was the greatest moment of my life. But this next moment, not so much.
We told you lay down for this match, but you did. Now you don't got no choice, Papa.
And then it got really bad. So I wake up in this rat hole, not knowing where I was, how I got here, or worst of all, who I was. All I know is my face feels like hamburger.
Ah, see, he is away. Es un milagro.
You must have angels that watch over you, senor. You shouldn't even be alive.
Senor, don't worry. We are going to help you.
I hate this pro bono crapola.
Shh! Stop it, estúpido!
Shouldn't be alive. Help me. Help me with what? What happened to me?
Este señor no va a tener futuro sin nuestra ayuda.
So here's what I've been told. Apparently, I was beaten to a pulp, and my lifeless body was left for dead in some dark alley in Tijuana. I was pounded so badly that nearly half the bones in my body were broken, and my face was demolished beyond recognition. But these doctors are actually plastic surgeons, and are offering to reconstruct my face into something that, won't scare the children, so they say. I'm not really sure why they're doing this for me, or what pro bono means. I'm just grateful that they are. Anyway, let's see what they can do. Well, I've got a new look, but I still don't know who I am or how I got here. All I know is that I have this overwhelming urge to slam people into a mat. So either I'm a wrestler, or I have anger management issues. Either case, for now, I just want to work off my coma-induced atrophy, relearn whatever skills I have, and make enough money to live. To avoid being thrown into prison, I decided to take my aggressions out in a wrestling ring. There happened to be a local wrestling competition in town, so I joined up. They put me in their special gauntlet match. Something felt right about that. Wow, this place is a piece of work. What's with the chickens? So anyway, here's the deal. This is a gauntlet match. When you win against one, another comes in to take his place. Now, for whatever reason, part of the gimmick is that if you win a gauntlet match, they shower you with pesos and send you to America for an international match at a real United States military base. Some kind of wrestling mock war of nations, I guess. Yeah, something definitely feels right about this.
Thank you.
Not exactly a regal way for the King of the Gauntlet to travel, but it's better than nothing. I'll take a free trip to the States any day.
Oh, Your Highness! So you're the Mexican King of the Gauntlet? I feel so honored to be in the presence of such royalty.
So you're that jobber from Tijuana who won a chance to get his butt beat here tonight, huh? What a joke.
Yeah, funny. Can you just point me to the locker room?
Your throne's over there, Your Highness.
That's a bathroom. Good one. I already feel the love.
Thank you. Yeah.